c'est... Oh, plus... Plus con.
Hi everyone, welcome to Gran Turismo. This is my first campaign, practice at campaign, which is offline. So what's the info? I've not seen this yet. First time I'm playing this. I had Gran Turismo Sport before this, so I'm looking forward to playing this. something. So I must be Shaggy Rage, ready for a new adventure, I see. Yeah. My name is Sarah, your guide in this world of Gran Turismo. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you, Sarah. Let me start by asking you first. Yeah. Have you ever travelled the world of Gran Turismo before? No. So the world of Gran Turismo is a world of cars. A world that is vast, rich and in depth. Shaggy Racing, let's get out there and explore this new world, okay? First of all, you'll be needing a car, okay? There's a used car dealer that offers cars at a reasonable price, so let's go check that out, right? I've got 20,000 credits. I'm going to the used car dealership. What do you fancy? Oh well, you must be on your first trip out. My name is Andy. I'm the owner of this dealership. Nice to meet you. Right now, this is the lineup of cars in stock. Some nice cars. I've had a Mini Cooper. They're cracking motors, man. Good fun. So yeah. Andy, could you give Shaggy Race 5 some advice on picking his first car? That's his error. Okay, no problem. When choosing your car, pay attention to the PP in addition to its looks and price. What's PP? Right. PV stands for performance points and indicates how fast the car is. Right, okay. The PP is a numerical value that gives you an overall indication of how fast your car is, taking into account its power, aerodynamics, handling and so on. Wow. The higher the PP is, the faster and stronger the car with aerodynamics, speed and everything combined into one. Since you're just at the beginning of your adventure, it'll be good to start out with a Japanese compact car. Right, okay. Well, the car in stock now, that would be these three. The Honda Fit, the Toyota Aqua, and the Mazda Demio. Right, okay. You can make your choice based on the PP design here. You're free to choose the one you like. See if there's anything else at that price range, I didn't really like it. Price of something. I wish you had 24,000. You definitely would be getting a Mini Cooper. Why did it say it's German? Or because it's BMW? Aye. But they're built in Britain. That's the thing I don't get. I put Minis, you say they're German. They're BMW. But yeah, they're still built in United Kingdom. And as well, to add more insult to that, the engine that's inside them is actually built by Peugeot. No, the rest of the parts, the posh parts in German, possibly. So possibly the rest of the parts are German, but for them, they're not even built in Germany, you know what I mean? So how can they be German if they're not built in Germany? That's what I'm saying. I'm German and I've been born in Scotland, you know what I mean? And I've never stayed in Germany all my life. Stupid man. Right, anyway. And the gameplay, the Demio X D-Tourm, I prefer Toyotas to... I think Toyotas are better motors than Mazda. Honda are good as well. So I've got choice of three. Between the Toyota and the Honda for me, I think. Aye. Tough choice. I think I'll go for the Toyota. Aye. Purchase the Toyota, it's 120 brake horsepower. How many newton meter of torque? Natural inspired. Truck with four wheel drive. Max torque is 11.11 kgfm at 35,000 revs per minute. I'll go for that. 14,300. That leaves me with 5,700. That leaves me with. So I wonder if I can do any modifications there. When you purchase a receiver car, you gain collector points according to the price and the value of the vehicle that you own or purchased. The more collector points you have, the higher your collector level will be. The collector level reflects your rank as a car collection. That's quite cool as well. So pick up lots of cars, increase your collector level. That's quite straightforward. I see you picked out your first car. Congratulations from Sarah. So Shaggy, race sign. This will be your first car. Once you leave here, I recommend going to your garage and checking out your new car. Okay. Right. So my garage now. my garage is new home, so I've got my main garage, that's my garage. Going into my garage. The garage, I stored space. This is the garage, I stored storage space for your car collection, right? Aye. This is the home base where you can switch cars, change settings, or really take a look at your collection, right, okay. You can also turn in tickets you get in Macy's and receive any bonus items as well. Once you've checked everything out, let's head. Right, so, aye, car settings. You can change the settings if car is currently driving. Settings sheet. Right. Use the button menu. Magazine assembles the end menu, top left, so take right. I can only use comfort tires, right, okay, aerodynamics, suspension. Ah, you can probably purchase all that later during the game, gifts, calculates and right. All your cars are on the register tier, alright. Quite a lot of new cars to fill your collection. Can you collect them all? So you got bloody Pokemon, eh? Collect them all. Right. Now we're going to the cafe. I'm going to the cafe, let's head to the cafe, okay. Still not done a race and I'm now 20 minutes into this. Sierra Cafe, it's really down the woods, right? This is a special place where people who love cars and even car designers come to visit. There will also be special menu for people like you exploring this world. Come on. Shaggy Ray Fine, let's go inside, okay. Luca, oh, so you're Shaggy Ray Fine. You're just starting out on a new adventure, right? Yeah. My name is Luca, the owner of this cafe. We not only serve food and drinks here, but also provide special menu books for exploring this world, right? Okay. The menu book contains hints and objectives to help you collecting cars and enjoying the racing. Once you complete one menu book, I'll have an R one ready for you. Okay. Let's start out by choosing the first menu book. Right, okay. Right. Collection Japanese compact cards. I've got one of them. Okay. So I need to collect them. The first menu I prepared for you is all about collecting Japanese compact cars. The goal is to simply acquire all three of these cars listed in this menu. You might have one or two of them already, but your work's not done until you've got them all three. You can receive the cars as rewarded for your performances in certain World Circuit races, too. An orange compass icon will guide you to races where the car you require can be won. Be sure to come back to the cafe once you've collected all the three cars. I'll be waiting. Right, okay. Yeah, right, that's that done. So it's gonna be. There's a wee orange thing there, cool. So we'll go there, and then that way I can win one of these cars that is on the menu. Right, okay. I hope on my settings are right, I hope I'm on a manual gearbox. I don't like auto, I prefer manual, but it's sequential. I've not got the gear stick set up because it moves about and that. I need it clamped, so I'm going to purchase something for that, a stand. Feel for it. Try to bloody find it. Thank you, Ben. There. Time machine. So I think, boys, it's the beginning. I don't know. So it's an automatic gearbox, which I fucking don't like, but I just need to do what the game wants me to do. Base knock up all of them, and then maybe later on, you know, come up to change the manual, because it doesn't seem like I can change it in my manual now. Definitely. I know you've got raging about that, because I prefer a manual gearbox. Thank you. a championship. I think. Assassin's custom assist preset, so it's in traction control, so turned it on to manual now. Turn traction control on the race motor now. Anyway, so Aye, nice to meet you. I'm not sure cool car and just had to say hi. Hey Stella, you're looking good as always. Her name is Stella. She likes cars a lot and comes to the cafe pretty often. Off talking about cars at this cafe. The Toyota Prius is the most famous Japanese hybrid car. And if we were too narrow of a field to compact cars, it would be the Aqua. Outside of Japan, the Aqua is marketed as the Prius C. But wait, perhaps I'm getting ahead of myself. Are you familiar with the term hybrid car? Like it's half electric, half petrol. Oh great, it's a car that runs on two power sources, a fuel burning engine and an electric motor. No, that aye. Electric motors are great for acceleration and allow for tight control. By balancing engine and motor power, hybrid cars offer a very efficient driving experience. Okay. Are you the owner of this car? Are you by chance Hideo Kodama, the man who helped to design many famous German cars at Opel? Indeed I am. It's a pleasure to meet for both of you. The pleasure is yours, Kodama-san. What an honour it is to make your acquaintance. Kodama-san was the chief designer at Opel Vauxhall. He worked there as a designer for more than 40 years, that's part of GM Group. He's also a judge at the prestigious and historic vintage car event, the Concorso di Eleganza Villa di Esther. This is one of Toyota's best designs in recent years. It's been over a decade since this car hit the streets. Yet, to see it today, you'd think it was novel. The low, height and double bubble roof account for a drag coefficiency of 0.28, allowing for a smooth ride. For the significance, canter windshield to the abruptly swapping rear. This car expresses a bold, clear vision. Thanks for your deeply insightful explanation. Michael Eiler, I hope we can discuss car design again sometime. Right, okay. So we got Anna. The term compact car is pretty explanation. It refers to cars with smaller wheelbases and less amplitude. New drivers love them because they are easy to handle and they are perfect for day-to-day use. Japanese compact cars are famous for their technical prowess. The diesel engine in the 4th generation demo is considered one of Lancer's masterpieces. There's also a 3rd generation Honda Fit Hybrid, the most fuel-efficient car in Japan when it was released. Finally, there's the Toyota Aqua, another compact hybrid, boasting great fuel efficiency and excellent hybrid handling. As you can see, many compact cars have ended up becoming all-time classics. Don't need to collect any cars for this man. Instead, I'd like you to check out the license centre. Earning licenses at the license centre is a great way to improve your driving skill if you're struggling. And if you're a more efficient driver, you can test yourself by trying to get gold in all challenges. Start off by earning a bronze prize or better in the first challenge for the National B license. Okay. Once that prize is in your back pocket, come back and eliminate. So I need to do the B license. Right, I really need to pee, so I'm gonna take a break, you know.